After a hot Sunday, temperatures barely cool down tonight. We're on the way to 70 by tomorrow morning. 68, 69, certainly possible town by town, but another warm one on the way for our Monday with a chance for some thunderstorms as a cold front gets close to us. We'll look for some of those afternoon thunderstorms to be around. Asheville and Hendersonville, a better chance for that as that front gets very near us tomorrow. So 82 in Asheville compared to 87 in Greenville. Look at the 90s still showing up in the southern part of the upstate as that front tries to dial back the temperatures. Then all of our attention will be on this, a developing tropical system which will likely become a hurricane and will be named Helene. So Hurricane Helene will be a name you'll hear a lot this week. It's nothing right now but a blob of moisture over the Caribbean. We've got to watch this specific area because it does stand now a high chance at becoming a named tropical system. Let's look at it. It's been tagged here recently as an Invest 97. Basically, this allows more model data, and they're beginning to fly planes around in this area to kind of zigzag and give our models critical data to give us a better output or a forecast. Winds are at 25 miles per hour. There's basically nothing organized, but as this pulls to the north into the Gulf, it likely will, possibly as early as Tuesday, but more than likely probably Tuesday night or Wednesday. Let's show you how this will play out. For us here at home, we're awaiting a front that's going to be coming our way late this week. That front is player number one. Player number two is this gathering low pressure toward the Caribbean. So Tuesday, midday, it's starting to get a better organized. By the afternoon and evening hours, it's now spilling north quickly. Now this front to the north is kind of steering and nudging it up toward the north right here, probably becoming a tropical storm or a hurricane by Wednesday. This lifts to the north and landfall looks to happen somewhere around Panama City Beach, Florida. This would be Thursday afternoon, Thursday evening. Now you got a couple of different things going on. That front's probably fizzled out at this point and it's beginning to send in some rain to our area. So as the day goes on Thursday, rain picks up, and by Friday, this system's moving north over Georgia. It's moving quickly, so it probably holds together some of its wind more so than if it were to be slowly moving north. That would mean more rain, less wind if it's a slow mover, but because it's moving fast, it holds together its wind. So it'll get very windy for us on Friday. Those gusts could get up to 40 miles per hour. As of this time frame of this model, it shows the core going over Atlanta and sending in the heaviest and highest rain for us Friday morning through midday, and then dialing it back a little bit by Friday evening. Here we go again, another week where do we play ball games on Thursday? Do we play them on Friday? The answer is probably to be determined, right? Because some of the models have some of that rain coming in Thursday, some of it having it Friday. Either way, Thursday and Friday look to be pretty wet across the area. As this moves out by Saturday morning, we're just left with a few lingering showers. Rainfall estimates look to be on the order of 3 to 6 inches along the track of that, including us here in the Western Carolinas and Northeast Georgia. Locally, what that looks like is rain picking up Thursday through Friday. Could be quite the soaking for us. 2 to 4 inches looks to be a good bet, with some areas west of town getting closer to 5. Some of those 5-inch areas could see some flooding, but right now it looks to be a good steady rain that we actually need. But you combine with it some high winds. Thursday, 11 p.m., we're starting to get breezy, 25, 30 mile per hour winds that could get up to 40 to 45 miles per hour by Friday morning. That's as the core is over Atlanta. Then as the day goes on, those higher winds shift to the mountains, 40, 50 mile per hour winds. And then by Friday evening, 5 o'clock, the heaviest winds, strongest winds are moving up toward Boone and up into Virginia. By Friday at 11, we're calming down, 10, 15 mile per hour winds left over. Rainfall totals. The computer models are getting into better agreement. The GFS certainly still going a lot more wild with rain across the area compared to the European. But either way, both are showing big time rain for us over the next week. So isolated thunderstorms tomorrow. We're a bit more sunny and dry on Tuesday before additional showers are possible Wednesday. Live Super Doppler 4 impact days begin Thursday into Fridays. We're tracking the tropics, and the eventual track can and will change, folks, so we'll keep you posted on that. Any deviation could mean higher or lower impacts for us. We're in the mid-70s due to the extra clouds and the rain. Clearing out throughout the day on Saturday, breezy, 76, nice and sunny, 74 on Sunday.